Hey guys, I wanted to share how I replaced the rear brake pads on my 2015 Maserati Ghibli SQ4. This model has Maserati branded Brembo brakes, 6-piston monoblock calipers in the front and 4-piston monoblocks in the back. These original pads lasted 24,000 miles before they started to squeak and annoy the hell out of me. The brake sensors didn't trigger yet, but when I went to replace the pads, they were getting real close anyways. I actually replaced the front pads a couple of weeks before the rear pads, but forgot to record a video of it. My bad. So I made sure to record replacing the rears. It's the same process other than an easy to remove bolt that holds the shims in place. The OEM Brembo pads run around $400 for the rears and $200 for the fronts. That's a bit steep in my opinion, but hey, they have the Brembo logo, so I guess that's what you pay for. I figured I should see if I can save a little money, so I did a little research on compatible non-Brembo pads and found ones that fit perfectly. For the rears, I bought the Brake Best Select Ceramic C1428 from O'Reilly's for $49.99. For the fronts, I bought the Perfect Stop by Wagner Ceramics PC1365 from Monument Car Parts for $34.95. These kits do not have the brake sensor, but that's okay, because you can disconnect them without warning lights popping up on your dash. I know, you're asking, how good are these pads? Well, the rears are the same ones used for the Tesla Model S, and the fronts are used for the Lexus ISF. I've already driven around 3,000 miles on these replacement pads, and they brake just fine. I've had a couple of hard braking events, and they clamp down and stop the car easily. They also make a hell of a lot less brake dust than the Brembo pads, so I like it a lot. Here's the stuff I used. I also used pliers and paper towels. These aren't in the shot. I didn't use the grease you see pictured. Instead, I used the Seal Glide for lubing. To tap out the pins, I used a nail set. You can probably find something else that would also work. Okay, let's get started. Jack up the car and remove the wheel. That goes without saying, right? Too late, I just said it. Once the wheel is off, I like to clean the caliper. At least the front part that you can see when the wheel is on. I use the nail set to tap the two pins out that hold the shim and pads in place. The front brakes have the same two pins and shim. You may need to use pliers to pull out the first pin. The shims that come with the kit are smaller than the stock ones, so I went ahead and cleaned the stock ones and reused them. There's a sensor cable connected to the inside pad that needs to be unplugged. Carefully unplug it without breaking the plastic tab. The old pads are a bit tight, so you just need to wiggle or shimmy them till they're loose. The new pads don't have a sensor, so I just zip-tied the sensor cable to secure it. I used Seal Glide to lube the new pads. Put a bunch on all the areas that touch metal. Make sure not to put any lube on the pad surface that touches the rotor. The pistons now need to be pushed back to make space for the new pads. You don't need any special tools for that. I took the old pad and carefully wedged it and pushed the pistons back into the caliper. You can use your fingers if you can get them to fit. Do this on both sides of the calipers. Insert the new pads, making sure they are facing the right direction. You don't want the lubed part to touch the rotors. Time to reassemble. Lube the pins, insert the first pin with the shim. I use the nail set to hammer both pins into place. Check the depth of the pins on the front side of the caliper. That looks good. Do this on the other side and you're all done. I hope this helps you out and saves you some cash at the same time. Thanks for watching. Peace.